Next topic is mastic patterns. See, letter L, we are making the pattern of L using mastics. So here how many mastics we have used? Two. We have used two here. What about here? Four. What about here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What about here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can continue like this. So we are getting numbers like this, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc., which we can write as 2 into 1. Here we can write 2 into 2. Here we can write 2 into 3. Here you can write 2 into 4. That means for 1L, it is 2 into 1. 2Ls, we take 2 into 2. So, second part is changing. What about 3Ls? We are taking 2 into 3. And 4Ls, we are taking 4 into L. 2 into 4. So, for making 1L, we need 2 into 1. For making 2Ls, we need 2 into 2 matchsticks. 3, we need 2 into 3 matchsticks. 4Ls, we need 2 into 4 matchsticks, and so on. So, what I said as variable means it can take any value. So, second part is changing. So, we can make a rule for this, taking this as 2N. So, for the first one, it is 2 into 1. Second, 2Ls, we need 2 into 2. 3Ls, we need 2 into 3. 4Ls, we need 2 into 4. What? This N is the variable which can take any value. So, if you want to make 60Ls, how many matchsticks you need? 2 into 60. If you want to make 100Ls, how many matchsticks you need? 100 means 2 into 100 matchsticks we need. So, if you want to make N, it is 2N. That is the rule. This is the rule for finding the number of matchsticks required to form the letter L. Similarly, for the letter C, how many matchsticks here? 1, 2, 3. So, for making one matchstick, we need 3. What about this? 3 plus 3, which is equal to 6. 6 matchsticks. What about this? 9 matchsticks. What about this? 12 matchsticks. So, how can you form the relation? This we can write as 3 into 1. For making 1C, we need 3 into 1. For making 2C, we need 3 into 2. For making 3Cs, we need 3 into 3. For making 4Cs, we need 3 into 4. So, second, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will change according as the number of C's. So, that we can take as the variable N. So, we can write the rule as 3N. We can write the rule as 3N. So, if you want to form 1C, how many matchsticks we need? 3 into 1. We can replace N by that number. If you want to make 3 C's, how many matchsticks you need? 3 into 3. If you want to make 100 matchsticks, if you want to make 100 C's, how many matchsticks you need? 3 into 100. Replace N by the number of matchsticks here. Number of C's, not matchsticks. So, replace N by the number of C's. Then, if you want to make 1000 C's, how many matchsticks you need? 3 into 1000. So, this is the general rule for making the number of, for getting the number of matchsticks required to make C. So, the general rule is 3N because we are using 3 C's for 1. Sorry, it is not like that because we are taking 3 matchsticks for making 1 C. So, letter F, how many matchsticks we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, isn't it? So here 8, here 12, here 16. So how can you write this? This we can write as 4 into 1, this we can write as 4 into 2, then 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16. So what is the general rule for this? To get the number of matrix required to make F, it is 4n. It is 4n. Then we can do exercise 11.1, first question. Find the rule which gives the number of matrix required to make the following matrix pattern. A pattern of letter E. So first one, how many we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So second one clearly 10, third one 15, then 20, etc. So how can you write 5? It is 5 into 1, 10, 5 into 2, 15, 5 into 3, 20, 5 into 4, and so on. So what is the general rule for this? It is 5n. You can take any alphabet as the variable, no problem. We can take any alphabet. So 5n. So what is the rule to get the number of matrix required to make E is 5n. Then a pattern of the subdivision is G. A pattern of letter A as like this. How many are we are using? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So first one is 6, 12, 18, etc. Which you can write 6 as 1 into 6, 12 as, we can write in the other way. Six into one, next six into two, next six into three, and so on. So what is the rule? 6n it is. So homework, exercise 11.1, first question A, B, C, D and F.